2016 was a difficult year for us because we saw changes on many fronts, not the least of which being the discovery that our oldest daughter was going through emotional difficulties and that she needed antidepressants, and also that she was enmeshed, she was trapped in some of the very habits that we had warned other young people against. For me personally, it was heartbreaking. It was so confusing. It didn't make any sense for me. I was upset with myself, you know, that I wasn't vigilant, that probably I didn't pray enough, I allowed the enemy to get past me and attack my family, you know, so there was a lot of self-condemnation. But I would just walk around her room when she wasn't there, you know, keep praying. I mean, it wasn't totally prayers of faith and, you know, knowing that God would do this, but it was partially that, but partially also confusion, unanswered questions, doubts. So I think 2017 was a year of healing, a year of refreshing for me personally. I'm a kind of person who wakes up normally with a song of worship, you know, but that had ceased for some time in my life. But now I began to sing again. I found myself praying in tongues once again, sometimes throughout the day, declaring the word of God over my children, particularly over my older one, despite the circumstances. And then come 2018, I think it's been a beautiful year of restoration. You know, answer after answer after answer to prayer on many fronts in our lives, particularly in the life of our oldest daughter. We saw many wonderful things happen during the year. And because Jesus Christ is healer and redeemer and restorer, we are trusting God for greater things, because we know that He's always the same and He never changes.